Hi, I'm Kayleigh Dowd and you join me today and we're at Harthill Reservoir. So we've come up, taken the short walk up to Reservoir 3. So it's home, it's mainly a carp fishery to be honest, owned by Embryo Family Fishing and the Canal and River Trust. But with carp fishing, as usual, you get some big bream and tench. So that's what we're here to target. So hopefully today we'll show you how to be patient, setting your stall out, putting some bait down and making little target areas is going to catch you them bigger fish after you've sat, waited and been rewarded. While we've got 5 minutes, I'm just going to run you through what bait I brought with me and what we're actually using. So main initial mix is this. So I've mixed a full bag, trusty old match method, just in original. Put that there so it doesn't blow away. And as you can see, it's nice and fine. Put through a riddle, got all them big lumps out of it. And if I give it a little squeeze, it makes a nice little ball. So that's full of all the attraction that I need. So I'm going to be feeding that loose, so I'm going to make a nice carpet and then feed a couple of little balls in it. You'll notice when you watch me feed it that I feed it just back from the end of the pole tip, so I'm fishing with the pole between my legs, but I'll feed that just back, so I'll feed it on my elbow with a little bit of pole left just to set the area there, and I'm fishing just past it. So I brought some baits with me, so I've got some dead maggots, a bit of a salted caramel corn, nice, smells lovely, does that? And then some maggots as well. So I'm going to pink odd maggot over. To be fair, I've got them left over from weekend, so I thought why not bring them with me because they could be useful. And then I've got 1/2 kilo of worms as well, which I'm going to put some chopped worm in there. So I'm looking for a ratio. I'll make a small mix, put a bit in there. So in the initial ground bait that I'm putting down, you're looking for something like that. So you've got the odd bit of corn in there, the odd maggot in there, but not full of particles. And then the little balls that I put in, you're going to have a bit more in there. So as you can imagine, you've got a nice little carpet of bait down, and then you've got two richer balls right where your pole tip is, where you're going to fish. Just because they're homing, eat on that, and then they get this nice little ball of bait, and that's where the target area is going to be. So we know it's going to be a patience game here. We are fishing for big fish and not many of them. So it's about being confident in what you're fishing in, setting your stall out and just being sat patient, waiting for them bites. And when the fish do come along, you've got to make the most of it then. Just about to put my initial feed in now, and as you can see, got quite a bit of it, so I've measured out 6 cups worth, so just the 250ml pots that you've got on the end of your pole. Put 6 pots of ground bait in of that, so we're using match method today. And because we're targeting bream and tench mainly, to that I've added a little bit of the F1 corn. Every bream and tench loves a bit of corn. Some dead maggots and some chopped worm. So if I hold up a little handful like that, you can see there's odd particles in there, and that's gonna make me base. So I'm going to feed some of them loose, or sand castles as some people know us. So what I mean by that is I'm literally going to get my pot, press it down a little bit, ship it out and put it down. So the aim of that is it's only about 3 foot deep out there, so it's not very deep at all. And it's going to make a nice little carpet. So rather than going down in 3 or 4 little balls, it's going to go down and sit on top of the silt. So it's quite a silty venue. So I'm going to have that little carpet. Then on top of that, I'm going to concentrate a little area and just put 2 little balls in. So I'm going to have my nice carpet where they're going to come and graze around, and then 2 target areas basically where I'm going to put my rig. So that's what I'm using, that's why I'm doing it. So I'm going to get it in so then we can get catching some fish. just while we're waiting for that bait to settle that we've just put in, I'm going to take this opportunity. Hopefully we'll be snarled up in catching fish to remember to do this bit later. So I thought we'll do it now. I'm going to show you what rig I'm going to be using and why I'm going to be using it. So we'll start at the top end. I've got a 13 Juras hybrid. So reason for using 13, even though we're only catching bream and tench, with it being shallow, there is carp in here, over 20 pound and quite a few of them. So if we do hook out like that, it'd be nice to get it in and have a look at. And this is quite stretchy, but it's on a puller. So we're gonna get everything in that will hook soft enough for them bream and tench, but big enough for them carp as well. With that, we've got a 017 power line. So that's down to an 015 power line again, hook length and a 14 GPM. So nice and durable. Like I say, if we do hook out, we want to get it in. And the float that I'm using today is a 0.5 gram power. So the reason why I've chosen a power is because the line goes through the middle of the body. It's nice and durable and it'll just sit there nicely and present well. So I want something that's going to hold me bait. Like I say, it's shallow, then fish are going to be moving round. I don't want something wafting round. I want it to sit nice and positive and just get a sharp dink when I get a bite. On these, I've got stots as well. So rather than using shot that can ping off with these big fish, stots are always a nice option when fishing sort of a commercial, if you want to call it that, or even like a big reservoir. If I were fishing for roach or bits like that, I'd use shot, but carp and bream, I don't mind using stots. So yep, that's the rig. So now we've waited a little bit, let them fish settle. I'm dying to have a go, so I'm gonna get out there. So there we go, that didn't take too long. Just need to find out what his first culprit is. Is it a tench? Is it a bream? I don't think it's a carp, but you never know. Had a couple of roach to start with, which is always gonna happen. But now these big fish have found this bait, I'd like to think we'll a few more to come. I'm going bream, I think. That elastic's perfect. As you can see, it's working, keeping the fish under control, absorbing any lunges. It's nice shallow water, just take your time, there's no rush. They are big fish. He's actually on a little bit of worm, this one. So we started on a bunch of maggots. Oh, is it? Oh no, it's tench. This shows what I know. I thought it were a bream. There we go. It's gonna come up. Lovely looking fish. One of my favourites is a tench. Just gotta watch these cameras that are in water. Why Zolt will be putting a claim in for some new ones. Look at that. Like bars of gold. There's not many places you can go and catch nice big tench these days. But this is one of them. Look at that. Nice little orange eye. Slime all up my line. Got itself wrapped round a bit there. Oh, it's undone. Come on, tench. In we go. There, lovely fish that is. Let's take a look out. There you go, that's his slimy line. Little bit of worm on end. That were his downfall. See if I can hold him up for you. It's quite slimy, but there we go. A quick look. There, look at that. Yeah. So I'll slip him back. I'm going to pot another little ball of bait in and get back out there. So we've got one. I've changed down. Just to a bit of a light of elastic, so we've got a 9 hollow on now. It's because the 13 turned out to be a little bit strong. The bream won't fight in that hard, so thought we'd have a little bit more of a play. But now it's when you've changed over, I'm not 100% sure it is a carp or a tench. I think it's a carp. It's pulling quite hard, to be fair. I saw one jumping distance, but I don't think it's that one. Just break down there just in case it runs. Where are we? We're coming in. It's all under control, just taking us time. Just plodding. Onto the top kit. Let's put that there. Still out there, but oh, it's going. I think it might be a carp, this one. Definitely not a bream, I'll tell you that. Let's take us time. So the carp do go quite big in here. So there's a few 20s. Average, I'd say, is 12, 15 pound. So chances are gonna be a nice one. Just gotta be careful when we get close to these inside snags, but we're doing all right for now. It's coming in. Is it a carp or is it a tench? After all this, it'll be a tench, won't it? Could be a tench, actually. Yeah. Who knows? I've got it wrong every time. Thought roach were bream, carp were tench. There we go. A nice little baby one. Still not that. Hold him up for you. Little fat one, this one. Nice and slimy. Look at that. Yay. Little, pop him in. There we go. Feed another little ball. Just keep dropping little balls out there and sit. Has been a bit of a waiting game, but when you wait and you get fish like that, who cares? So now I'm going to speak to you about this. This is a good sign because it means you've caught a fish, but also you need to clear it. Don't ever go out with that on your line. I don't think many people will, but it's important. If you just keep pulling it down, it gets to a shot and it'll come off. Pull it down. See there, that's what I caught my last one on. Bit of worm, there were a maggot on there as well. Yeah, makes nice little snot balls. Just make sure that all your lines, even them little bits behind your shot, you don't want any of that left. So there we go, ready to go again. Nice and clean, and that's how it should be before you go out. Bring it back in, get covered in snot, and go again. Gonna catch one more fish hopefully and then call it a day. So I've had a mega day's fishing, caught some lovely big bream, a few tench, and hopefully you've learnt a few things along the way too. Like I say, this sort of fishing is all about being patient. We've sat here now, little bit of worm on, tip with a maggot, and we're just waiting for that float to go under. I've had a brilliant day. I've swapped elastics, I explained that during the video. So that 13, I thought it'd be all right if we hook a few carp and forgiving enough on bream. But to be honest, it took the joy out of it. I've hooked the bream and they just come in. Whereas with this, got a little bit more play. Still hopefully get a carp in on it. It's strong enough for that. It'd just take a little bit longer. but we've not been pestered too much by the carp. So I've fished that power, so I've got a 0.5 power, and as it's only quite shallow, it's just sat there perfect all day, the odd little indication, but it's not been wafting round when the fish came in or anything like that. Just a little bulk, two droppers, and we're sat. And as I've said, that bit of worm's been the best bait. I have tried a couple of maggots and other baits, but we've got a few roach on that. The worm's been the standout bait. So for now, I'm hoping for that one last fish. What will it be? Nobody knows. I'm not going to guess because I've got it wrong 90% of the time. I got one right when it came to the top, but that was about it. Oh, I've gone. And it's another bream. So that didn't take long, literally sat there. Ooh, it's done a little splashes, this one. Big fish these are, to be honest. They are mega impressive. There's not many places where you can come on a pole, quite a few venues on a feeder where you can come and catch them, but there's not many venues at all on a pole where you can fish 13 metres on a reservoir and catch big bream. And these are big. They're not skimmers, these are proper bream, these. Old slimy warriors, that's what we're going to call them. We've got odd tench mixed in, we've had a couple of tench. Oh, I think it's wrapped round there. It's doing a little bit of a sideways walk, but is in the net. Oh. Big. Got to put my top kit down to lift these up. It's a two-hand job. They're heavy. You see the size of them. Look at that. Still got his bit of worm in his maggot hanging out of his mouth. Look at the size of that. How big are they? Massive. You can see that. Take that out, still his little bit of worm and maggot. I'm going to hold him up and say thanks for watching. Hope you've enjoyed the video. Make sure you check him out on YouTube and I'll see you on the next one. Cheers, guys.